In this video, we're going to be focusing on octet rule exceptions. So we're going to be looking at Lewis structures where the central atom has either less than or more than 8 electrons, because following the octet rule means having 8 electrons. We need to look at some atoms that don't necessarily follow that rule. Common examples of atoms that have less than 8 electrons are hydrogen and boron. Hydrogen is an extremely small atom. It only has one energy level, and it can only handle having 2 electrons. So you will find hydrogen with one single bond and no more. That's an exception to the octet rule. Another common example is boron. Boron is very often stable with only 6 electrons. So it's very common to find boron with just 3 single bonds. So that would be boron with only 6 electrons or hydrogen with only 2. Those are exceptions to the octet rule. Let's look at some examples, and then we'll come back and look at exceptions where they have more than 8 electrons. We will begin by drawing a Lewis structure for boron trifluoride, BF3. The first thing that you should always do is total your valence electrons. As a reminder, there's a trend on the periodic table that helps you figure out how many valence electrons each atom has. The atoms in group 1 have 1 valence electron. These have 2. Skip the transition metals, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 valence electrons. In this structure, we have 1 boron. Boron is here with 3 valence electrons. 1 times 3 is 3. This structure has 3 fluorines. Fluorine is here with 7 valence electrons. 3 times 7 is 21. Add those together. When I'm done with this structure, I should have 24 valence electrons drawn. The next step is to arrange the atoms with the least prevalent atom in the middle. So there's 1 boron and 3 fluorines. Boron should go in the middle with a single bond to each of the 3 fluorines. The last step is to compare what I have drawn to the number of valence electrons that should be present. So I have drawn 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24 valence electrons. Remember that a bond counts as 2 electrons. I should have 24 valence electrons. So what I have drawn matches what I should have. This is a good Lewis structure for boron trifluoride. Now remember that boron is most of the time stable with 6 electrons. There are cases where boron has 8. So if I had gotten to this last step and I needed 2 more electrons on this structure, it would have been perfectly fine to add them right there to the boron and complete its octet. The other type of octet rule exception would be having more than 8 electrons. This is going to apply to elements that are in period 3 on the periodic table or below. So the first 2 periods of elements cannot do this. But if you're in period 3 or below, then these elements can handle having more than 8 electrons. Remember when we did electron configuration and we called this row the 3s? This was the 3p, here was the 4s, and then this was the 3d. That energy level dropped by 1. So the elements in period 3 or below have an empty d subshell that they can use, and we call this an expanded octet. It allows those elements to handle having more than 8 electrons. An example would be sulfur hexafluoride, SF6. So let's draw the Lewis structure. This structure has 1 sulfur. Sulfur has 6 valence electrons. 1 times 6 is 6. There are 6 fluorines. Fluorine has 7 valence electrons. 6 times 7 is 42, for a total of 48 valence electrons. The next thing that you want to do is arrange the atoms with the single most atom in the middle. So sulfur goes in the middle, and then there are 6 fluorine atoms around it. The next step is to complete the octets. So each of these fluorines started with 2 electrons. 6 more were added to each fluorine. Sulfur started with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 electrons, but that's okay. Check the periodic table, find sulfur. Sulfur is in period 3 or below, so it is okay for it to have an expanded octet. It is okay for sulfur to have more than 8 electrons. Once you've completed those octets, you want to count all of the electrons that you have drawn. Remember that bonds count as 2. I have drawn 48 electrons. I should have had 48. This is a great Lewis structure for sulfur hexafluoride. This last example is going to be sulfur tetrafluoride, so 1 sulfur and 4 fluorines. Each sulfur has 6 valence electrons. Each of the fluorines has 7 valence electrons. We should have a total of 34 valence electrons. Next, you want to arrange the atoms with the least prevalent atom in the middle. So I've put sulfur in the middle with 4 fluorines around it. Then it is time to complete the octets. The sulfur already had a completed octet. It had 4 bonds around it. Each bond counts as 2. That's a total of 8 electrons. Each of these fluorines had 1 bond, that counts as 2 electrons, so I've added 6 more electrons to each of the fluorines. I have completed the octets for all of the elements in the structure. Then it's time to compare what I have drawn to the number of valence electrons. I have drawn 32 total electrons, and I should have 34. So there's a problem there. This structure is missing 2 electrons. Our rules tell us that those electrons should go on the central atom, and those rules are in the description if you need them. So we're going to add the extra electrons to the central atom. It looks a little strange, but this is what the Lewis structure for this structure should look like. The last thing you want to do is ask yourself, is it okay for sulfur to have more than 8 electrons? And it is, because sulfur is in period 3 or below, so it is perfectly fine for sulfur to have an expanded octet. This is an appropriate Lewis structure for sulfur tetrafluoride. That completes our discussion of Lewis structures. Stick around as we look at how we can use those Lewis structures to predict the shape of a molecule. In the next video, we're going to be talking about the Vesper theory.